Nach seinem erfolgreichen Studiengang an der Harvard Business School und an der Stanford Universität in den Vereinigten Staaten und des Erwerbs des Masters in Betriebswirtschaftslehre und eines weiteren Masters für internationale Wirtschaftsbeziehungen mit Schwerpunkt Europäische Einigung, arbeitete er zunächst bei McKinsey sowie bei griechischen Banken. Seit März 2004 ist er Abgeordneter der Demokratia im griechischen Parlament und von Juni 2013 bis Januar 2015 war er Minister für Verwaltungsreform und EG-Government im Kabinett Samaras. Er gilt als Reformer und Europakenner. In seiner Amtszeit als Minister hat er Mitsotakis eine umfangreiche Verwaltungsreform eingeleitet und ein neues Bewertungssystem bei den Beamten eingeführt. Kyriakos Mitsotakis wurde am 10. Januar 2016 von der Parteibasis und Unterstützern der Nea Dimokratia zum Parteivorsitzenden gewählt. Seit 2016 ist Mitsotakis der Oppositionsführer im griechischen Parlament. Umfragen, wenn man sie glauben darf, deuten darauf hin, dass Herr Mitsotakis nach der nächsten Parlamentswahl in Griechenland, also noch in diesem Jahr, gute Chancen hat, das Amt des Ministerpräsidenten für sich zu entscheiden. Lieber Kyriakos, nun bitte ich dich ums Wort. Herzlichen Dank.
Stavros, thank you very much for your kind words, and I hope your predictions prove to be accurate, as 2019 is going to be a critical year for Europe, and it's also going to be a critical year for Greece. And I think what is going to happen in Greece is relevant for the rest of Europe for several reasons. When we turn the clock back to 2009, Greece found itself at the very epicenter of the debt crisis. It has unfortunately become a poster child for a problematic European country, an honor I feel it does not deserve. And it also found itself in the midst of the migration crisis, which also caused real rifts within the European Union, and was also the first country to actually elect into power a populist government back in 2015, coming from the left, which however formed a coalition government with another populist party coming from the right. And unfortunately, over the past 3 years, not enough progress has been made in Greece. Although the potential for a robust recovery is clearly there, unfortunately, it has not been fully realized. The economy has underperformed, growth has been anemic, investment levels remain incredibly low. The banks are still saddled with lots of non-performing loans, and full market access after the end of the program has not yet been restored. However, I feel that the 2019 could be a real catalyst for our country, as I think that a big political change could send a very clear signal that Greece is ready to change and is ready to unlock its real growth potential. I have very, very clear plans when it comes to the future of our country. Greece is a country endowed with significant natural comparative advantages. It's a country which has suffered a lot over the past 10 years. It has lost 25% of its GDP. More than 500,000 Greeks have left the country. Many have come to Germany, to Bavaria. We train wonderful doctors only to serve in German hospitals simply because we cannot provide them with good enough jobs. What Greece needs is an investment-driven growth, and this can only come if it sticks to its fiscal targets and if at the same time it delivers real and meaningful structural reforms to attract foreign investment but also unlock the potential for domestic investment. I am fully committed in leading Greece towards this path and in putting in place an aggressive reform package that will make Greece again an attractive investment destination. And at a time when the global economic environment does not look as benign as it did maybe 2 to 3 years ago, Greece could be a very pleasant surprise story when it comes to growth. And when it comes to the relationship between Greece and Germany, it is very important for me to change the narrative. this no longer should be a discussion about debtors versus creditors, about how much money we owe to Germany. This should be a discussion about the future, about investment opportunities, about what we can do together, about how Greece can participate in the common European projects in areas of common interest, such as defense and such as migration. These topics are going to be particularly important, not just in Greece, but they're also going to be important within the context of the next European election. But take a close look at what's going to be happening in Greece, because essentially what we see today in Europe is a constant narrative about the threat of populism, whether it comes from the right or whether it comes from the left. In this sense, Greece was ahead of the curve. We elected the populists into power. Trust me, they don't do a good job. So if you want to experiment going down that direction, always keep the Greek example in mind. The real question is what comes after populism. And I think what we are ready to see in Greece is what I call the politics of post-populism. The pendulum is swinging back towards the need for moderation, reason, competence, values, all those values that are at the center of our big European political family, the European People's Party, but that also constitute the core of European values that will be challenged in this upcoming elections. So I think this is a time for cautious optimism. It's a time to rephrase the political narrative, both in Greece and in Europe. And I hope that after the next elections, Greece is going to be able to punch above its weight, not just by delivering robust economic growth domestically, but also by participating in the next phase of the European integration project, especially in areas such as migration and defense, where it should have a very clear saying as to what is going to happen in Europe. Again, thank you very much for giving me the opportunity to participate in this Congress. And I wish, I hope, that 2019 is going to be a good year, not just for Greece, but also for the European political mainstream parties. Thank you very much.